This list about some of the things my mother taught me has been making the rounds online. My mother taught me logic. My mother taught me to meet a challenge. What were you thinking? Answer me when I talk to you. Don't talk back to me. My mother taught me how to become an adult. If you don't eat your vegetables, you'll never grow up. My mother taught me about genetics. You are just like your father. My mother taught me about my roots. Do you think you were born in a barn? My mother taught me about the wisdom of age. When you get to be my age, you will understand. My mother taught me about anticipation. Just wait until your father gets home. And my all-time favorite thing, justice. One day you will have kids and I hope they turn out just like you. Then you'll see what it's like. Mother's Day is a time when children pay respect to their mothers. Children often give their mothers a gift and a card. And these days, even grown-up sons or daughters might take their mothers out for a Sunday lunch or carvery. Many churches like to give the children in the congregation a little bunch of spring flowers such as daffodils or a pot of some lovely primulas to give to their mothers as a thank you for all their care and love throughout the year. That is such a nice idea too. Mother's Day is not a fixed day in the calendar, of course, because it is always the middle Sunday in Lent, which lasts from Ash Wednesday to the day before Easter Day. This means that Mother's Day in the UK will fall on different dates each year and sometimes even fall in different months, and it seems that since the 16th century we have been celebrating this day under a variety of names and traditions, known as Refreshment Sunday or Pudding Pie Sunday or Mid-Lent Sunday, the more usual being Mothering Sunday. It was a day in Lent when the fasting rules were relaxed, some say in honour of the story of the feeding of the 5,000, a miraculous story in the Bible involving Jesus and a boy with some fish and some bread. But not that long ago, young girls and boys in service, maids and servants that is, who worked at the local manor house, for example, were only allowed one day to visit their family each year, and this was usually on Mothering Sunday. For some, this could be a long journey involving a lot of walking, and often the housekeeper or cook would allow them to bake a fruitcake, such as simnel, to take home for their mother. A flat layer of marzipan was placed on top of it, and it was decorated with 11 marzipan balls representing the 12 apostles, minus Judas, of course, who betrayed Christ. Some people, I'm told, created a depression in the centre of the cake mixture before baking, so that it rose with a hollow middle into which they would put small eggs made of homemade marzipan. Sometimes a gift of eggs or flowers from the garden or hothouse was allowed to be taken too. Someone has written, maids were put into service for the landed gentry and paid a small salary but boarded free of charge. They dealt with everything from cleaning, washing to cooking, so to have a day of rest and be able to visit their mother was quite a privilege. The wonderful actress Sarah Gordy, who starred in the 5th episode of the latest series shown of Call the Midwife, has become an internet star. Sarah appears in a beautiful, moving video promoting World Down Syndrome Day, raising awareness of the potential of those people who have Down syndrome and to recognize the contribution of those who live and work with them. The video, found on YouTube, is a reply to a letter received by a worried mother of a baby with Downs, who writes, "I'm expecting a baby. I've discovered he has Down syndrome. I'm scared. What kind of life will my child have?" Sarah Gordy and others reassure this mum by showing her their own wonderful lives and experiences. Anybody who saw Sarah's beautiful performance in Call the Midwife will know that a child born with Down syndrome is capable of astonishing talent and potential. It seems the world is getting the message, as the video has already been seen by over 1 million people in just 2 weeks. What a beautiful thing to do for one worried mother.
Visit our website, gravityfm.net. Local radio for local people.
On Gravity FM.